Meine Damen und Herren, liebe Boxsportfreunde, willkommen zum nächsten Kampf des heutigen Abends. 10 Rounds for the vacant WBA Continental Championship in the Super Middleweight Division. 10 Runden WBA Continental Championship im Super Mittelgewicht. Begrüßen Sie auf dem Weg in die blaue Ecke. Kommt zu uns all the way, making his way to the blue corner. Kama Maloku.
Gentlemen, Kama Maloku makes his way to the ring. The 33-year-old, originally from Kosovo, now plies his trade in Karlsruhe, Germany. 16-2, 13 KOs. Funnily enough, he lost his first two fights as a professional. Took about 2 years out and has since been on the beat streak. So two losses came in fight number one and fight number
Come
two.
On, that is correct. Und nun, meine Damen und Herren, kommt zu uns in die rote Ecke. Ein großer Applaus, making his way to the red corner. Well,
Germany, Uwel Hernandez, 13-1, excuse me, with 7 KOs to his name. Only loss came against Jörg Schicka back in 2019, lost a unanimous decision, white-ish on the scorecard, 24, lost out in March of this year. Beat Mafia Jackie for the IBO Continental Super Middleweight title. Also a German champion, won the German title against Chris Herrmann back in December of 2020. And he'll be looking to add the WBA Continental Super Middleweight title to his collection this evening.
Meine Damen und Herren, ladies and gentlemen, 10 rounds for the vacant WBA Continental Championship in the Super Middleweight Division. Gewichtslimit Super Mittelgewicht 76,2 Kilogramm. Ich darf ihn wie immer zuerst offiziell vorstellen. The officials, the supervisor from Panama, Julio Time. Should this fight go the distance? Sollte der Kampf über die volle Distanz gehen, sind die drei Punktrichter. René Fiebig aus der Bundesrepublik Deutschland. José Ignacio Martinez aus Spanien. Und Michel Baxiuta aus Belgien. Come in to the fighter in the blue corner. Die blaue Ecke. 33 Jahre ist er alt, brachte gestern beim Wiegen 75,4 Kilogramm auf die Waage und misst 1,80 Meter. Er ist Profi seit 2013. Sein Kampfrekord 18 Kämpfe, 16 Siege, 13 Mal gewann er durch K.O. All the way from Karlsruhe, Germany, Kamer Maloku. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the red corner, die rote Ecke. Er ist 29 Jahre jung, brachte gestern beim Wiegen 75,6 Kilogramm auf die Waage, misst ebenfalls 1,80 Meter. Er ist Profi seit 2017. Sein Kampfrekord, 14 Kämpfe, 13 Siege, 7 Mal gewann er durch K.O. He's the former German champion, the reigning IBO Continental Champion, all the way from Havana, Cuba, now hailing from Munich, Germany, Uwel Hernandez. The referee in charge of the action, der Ringrichter, ist Oliver Brien aus der Bundesrepublik Deutschland.
So here we are, ready to go, 10 round title fight. coming up.
Ladies and gentlemen, seconds out. 10 rounds for the vacant WBA Continental Championship in the super middleweight division. Weight limit 76.2 kilograms. Seconds out, Ringfrei Runde 1, round 1.
So Hernandez in the white and silver shorts. Maluku in the black and red. Donning the Albanian crest on his shorts, showing some respect to his heritage. First 30 seconds. Luka goes for a jab to the body, doesn't quite connect. But just trying to find his range. Good shot to the body from Hernandez. Makes Maluku stumble ever so slightly. Top, not too much oomph in it, but does require Hernandez to take a retreat. For a few seconds, Maluku go to work on the body, trying to go upstairs. Hernandez covered up well. Finding his right hand around the guard of Maluku. First round, I think the cleaner work, the more of the work came from Hernandez. Some of the replays from the first round for you here, ladies and gentlemen. So a lot on the line here, ladies and gentlemen. Ranking places up for grabs. In the WBA. Obviously, Sal Canelo Alvarez holds the all the cards in this division at the moment. He's obviously due to fight Gennady Golovkin this summer. A fight I'm sure all boxing fans are eagerly anticipating. I certainly am. In the jab, and again. Mendes constantly moving. Maluku launches an attack, but Hernandez been moving well so far in this contest. We'll just go over the halfway point of round number two. By both men. We're coming to the final minute, final 45 seconds. Little bit of a cagey affair so far. This one is scheduled to 10, so hopefully things will heat up. Very technical so far. Both men. Good shot to the chin. So here's some replays. It's not the most exciting fight so far, but a long, long way to go. Both men showing decent ring craft in there. Lesser-ish opposition after his sole career defeat. Maluku on a bit of a knockout spree, 13 KOs in his 16 wins. It gives you an idea what Maluku will be trying to do. Despite the impressive knockout stats, Maluku, a very capable boxer, a 33-year-old. attempts a big wild swing after a peppering to the body from Hernandez. Hernandez with good head movement there. So halfway round of round number three. Halfway through round number three, I should say. Hernandez making this apparently frustrating for Maluku. Nothing and completely irrelevant. Maluku can get another impressive knockout to add to his collection. So quite a few seconds. Round number three. Replay. Fedman doing decent work, but nothing's really rocking the boat of both either men at the moment. So it's still pretty cagey. Hernandez started this round quickly, came right out, kind of in the combination. Good right hand around the guard from Hernandez. Movement from Hernandez once again.
Hey, go!
moving out of danger's way there. Final 25 seconds of round number four. Chris Pelocco in the corner, looking at this well to get out of the way. Catches him with the jab round the end of the round. That brings an end to round number four. Replays me here, ladies and gentlemen. Yet to really set fire this one. Been cagey to say the least. I thought Hernandez had probably his best round so far. WBA Continental Super Middleweight title on the line. Hernandez, pretty good right hand. Maluka takes one himself. Hernandez blocks it, and he blocks it again. Well, Hernandez's defensive work has been pretty impressive the last two, three rounds. Deals with it pretty well. Jab from Hernandez. Another attempted jab and a hook to the body. Maluku gets out of the way of both of them. Quite well. That's both men good defensively. Hasn't made for the most blistering fight, I'll be perfectly honest with you. Brings an end to round number five as we hit the halfway point of this contest. Good shot from Hernandez in the replays. Yeah. word, mate. Much needed in structure. So this is the halfway stage right now. She's about to move into the second half of the fight. It's round number six. Both men just trying to work each other out still, not trying to give too much away, not wanting to take too much of a chance. I've got Hernandez starting to put away now, though. I've gotten taken the last two or maybe even three rounds, I would say definitively. Hernandez potentially pulling away the rounds. But Maloku does have that knockout power and has the ability to end this at any time. Maloku attempts the hook but misses Hernandez. Saw that coming a mile away. Round number six. At the moment, Hernandez doing the better work in this round. Maloku struggling with the defensive prowess of the Cuban. Here we are into round number seven. The cheers of Hector coming for Uwel Hernandez. Who's starting to show his quality in here. starting to chip off these rounds, in my opinion. Pretty cagey start. Still pretty cagey, to be fair. But got the last three rounds going in favour of Hernandez. And you could argue a case that he picked up pretty much all the previous rounds, but I don't think they were pretty close. So I think the judges are going to split those rounds, in my opinion. But we're going to find out if it does even come to that. Trying to come forward and find an opportunity for attack. Good jab from Hernandez. Very nice. Just as Maluku's coming forward. Hernandez rips out, nice jab. There's another, just little flashes of quality coming from the Cuban. Nice shot to the body with the left hand from Hernandez. Maluku definitely not giving up. He's still 100% in this fight, despite the last couple of rounds appearing to go the way of Uwel Hernandez. Another shot to the body from Hernandez. Gets out of danger's way from the left hook from Maluku. He tries to go upstairs. Maluku does catch him with something. They don't really seem to bother him now. So final 10 seconds. A round number 7. Maluku do some damage. He can. Lands a shot there. With Hernandez up against the rope. Hernandez comes back himself with a right hook round the guard. That brings an end to another round. Shot to the body there from Hernandez. Once again, I think I've got to get that as a Hernandez round. On the unofficial Adam Noble Forsey scorecard. But Maluku's still there. Not hurt in any way. I think he's being outmoved by the Cuban at the moment. As we said, Maluku on a mean winning streak and knockout streak. Last time he didn't knock someone out was against Attila Korda all the way back in 2018. Since then, put 10 knockout victories together. So just three rounds left, or just under three rounds left. Maluku's gonna have to start putting his foot on the gas. Good shot to the body there from Hernandez. There's a little combination, finding the... And then Maluku comes back, and then he has some success there. Hernandez doesn't seem to be too concerned about the power of Maluku in these later rounds. Quite happy to just stand there and carry on with his work at times. Hernandez trying to cut off the ring. Last in this one. amazed by it. Bit of a vicious attack there from Kamen Moloku. The body catches Hernandez again. Oh, Hernandez catches Moloku coming out on the inside. Final 10 seconds of round number 8, and that's just 2 rounds to go, ladies and gentlemen. So much better round for Kamen Moloku. Some of the best success he's had for a good 4 rounds. There you go. Moloku catches the jab there in the replay, and he took an uppercut. And this is where it was straight after that that Moloku had some serious success. So they tangle up the feet there. Hernandez still landing nice, crisp, clean shots. He's probably taken that round as well. There was a little spurt of energy there from Moloku, but the skill of Hernandez shining through at the moment. Towards the ropes. Shots from Hernandez at the beginning of this round. Moloku having a little bit of success just over the halfway stage of round number 9. Good jab there from Moloku. Going to need a bit more of that. Then Hernandez comes forward with a good combination, rattling the skull of Moloku. Side there from Hernandez. Moloku comes forward and Hernandez catches Moloku on the way in. Nice hook on the inside, catching him. Seconds of round number 9, and Hernandez appearing to be in control of this contest. Just to say that, Moloku comes forward with an attack. He's got Hernandez pinned against the rope, and Hernandez with a good shot to make Balogun retreat, and it hits him with another good jab. Lucky attempts a wild shot over the top, and Hernandez is far too aware of that. After a reasonably slow start to this contest, this one's a big shot there from Malocco. Took that well. You see his mouth guard comes loose in his mouth, but he has to readjust his mouth guard and keep himself on his feet at the same time. So another good round for Hernandez. Gentlemen, good, nice to see that, fantastic sportsmanship. I've noticed, especially within German boxing as well. At home, if you are scoring it, we've got Hernandez. Good few rounds ahead on the scorecards. Shot to the body from Hernandez. Comes in Malocco with a jab. Malocco covers it well. I think he's going to need a knockout if he wants to win this. He has got it in his locker. Can he pull it off? Can he hit Hernandez? Hernandez has not taken a lot of punishment. I'd be surprised if one big shot did. Was able to knock him out. He hasn't really received much damage in this fight. He's received some damage, but much damage would be false. Okay, final 50 seconds, and it appears Uwel Hernandez is going to be adding to the trophy cabinet. Good work from Hernandez. Getting in an advantageous way. Malocco stumbles slightly. I think it was more of a slip rather than anything else. Both men did themselves no discredit, but I think Hernandez has taken that one reasonably wide on the scorecards. But Malocco in trouble in round 8. Making him stumble back to the ropes. Be interesting to see how the judges score this one. But that one fought in a tremendous spirit. Started pretty slow. And then Hernandez started to pull away on the scorecards. So we'll eagerly await the scorecards, ladies and gentlemen. And we're flying through the evening's fun. After this, we've only got three fights left. Can you believe that, ladies and gentlemen? Gone so quick. Timo Ross up next. He'll be taking on Mariusz Bykuski. And then we've got Ramona Grave taking on Alit Sanchez for the vacant WBA gold female super featherweight title. There we are. Been great sportsmanship throughout the evening's entertainment tonight from all fighters. Good to see. A lot of respect being shown.
Und José Ignacio Martinez scored in the fight 97-94. We got a winner by unanimous decision.